Thank you for attending this webinar. Today's aim is to give you an overview of what you can achieve with in vivo delivery reagents, also called in vivo transfection reagents. There is a wide range of applications from gene function studies in physiological and/or disease models to developing gene therapies. In vivo nucleic acid delivery can also be called in vivo transfection. In vivo transfection is the art of introducing naked nucleic acids into cells, just like a standard in vitro transfection system, except that it needs to happen in an in vivo setting. In this first part, we will go over why you may need to use an in vivo approach, in case you are not familiar with the range of applications, how, which methods can be used to deliver nucleic acids in vivo with their advantages and drawbacks, and what we, as experts in transfection, have developed to make in vivo delivery a method accessible to all scientists. Why deliver nucleic acids in vivo? In vivo nucleic acid delivery is performed in live animals to confirm in vitro results and/or to study a gene function in vivo. Clearly, transient in vivo delivery of nucleic acid is a useful tool that offers a complementary or alternative method to generating a transgenic animal model. Complementary, because it can already allow you to generate data on the effect of silencing of the gene of interest or overexpression of a wild-type or mutated gene in the animal model. Alternative method, especially when the mutant transgenic animal model is not viable or not fertile. Instead of generating inducible transgenic mice, in vivo transient transfection is an easier and faster approach. In vivo delivery does not only have to be transient. It can also be used to generate transgenic models, genome editing based approach, such as CRISPR-Cas9. And finally, it is also a method that is growingly used to develop gene therapies, particularly to treat cancer. Let us first focus on nucleic acid delivery in animal models, which is a key step between in vitro research and human clinical trials. How to deliver nucleic acids in vivo? There are two options: viral vector-based or chemical-based delivery. The first option is to use a viral vector containing the nucleic acid of interest. This is a commonly used method to deliver nucleic acids in vivo because it has several advantages. It is highly efficient and you can target specific tissues or cells. There are limitations. You need a suitable biosafety environment to manipulate and produce viral vectors. The size of the nucleic acid is limited, and the direct injection of viral vector can trigger an immune response in your animal model. The second option is to use a non-viral method, under which you will find the following approaches: naked nucleic acid delivery, physical mediated methods, chemical-based nanoparticles. In today's webinar, we will focus on chemical-based nanoparticles. This technique is simple and reliable. We engineer polymers that can interact and encapsulate nucleic acids in tiny nanoparticles that can penetrate the tissue to make sure that the nucleic acid reaches the targeted cell. The advantage over viral methods are safety, no immune response triggered, no biosafety concerns, and easiness of use and cost effectiveness. The main drawback is that some tissue cell types are more challenging than others to transfect, and this is the case with any non-viral delivery method. Hence, the use of viral-based methods for specific cell types. Another point to raise is that the nanoparticles have no specific tropism, which means that they can potentially target any cell type. There are ways to enhance delivery to specific tissues and cell types. We will go over them shortly. So what methods have we developed for robust in vivo delivery? We had specific concerns that we wanted to address when we developed our in vivo delivery reagent. We wanted it to be easy to use, accessible to all scientists, and mimicking as closely as possible an everyday in vitro transfection protocol. polyvalent, delivery of any type of nucleic acid, DNA, mRNA, sRNA, short oligonucleotides, mRNA, etc., to target any type of organ, so no tropism, and in any animal model. That's indeed the case with our polymer-based transfection reagent. That is used as the in vivo delivery reagent in over 700 published in vivo studies, and also used up to clinical trials. So we have the expertise to provide tailored protocols for your in vivo models that are also less common. All of that with our in vivo jetPEI, injectable, easy and safe method for in vivo transfection. Now that we have gone over the why, the what, and the how of in vivo delivery, the second part will be focused on giving you, in a nutshell, how in vivo jetPEI works. As I mentioned, we wanted in vivo jetPEI to be an easy-to-use method accessible to all scientists. What does the protocol look like? It is a two-step protocol similar to an in vitro transfection protocol. Simply, pre-dilute the nucleic acid in the provided glucose solution, do the same with in vivo jetPEI, mix the two together, wait for 15 minutes at room temperature, and that's it. The nanoparticles are formed and ready to be directly injected in the animal model, either systemically or locally. All the mentioned administration routes have been used to deliver in vivo jetPEI nucleic acid nanoparticles, systemically, intraperitoneal injection, intravenous, tail vein or retroorbital, and locally, topical, nasal instillation, intracerebral, intratumoral, subcutaneously, and many others. In vivo jetPEI is suitable for delivery of any type of nucleic acid to target any animal model, common ones such as mice and rats, to more exotic ones such as rabbits, fish, flies, ants, and many others. To target any organ, again, lack of a specific tropism. As shown here below, you can appreciate that even when systemic, the administration route can already dictate the organs to which the nucleic acid will be more or less delivered. When DNA in vivo jetPEI nanoparticles are injecting using the intravenous route or the intraperitoneal route, you can see clear differences in several organs: lung, heart, salivary glands, intestine, spleen, and ovaries. Safety is, of course, a major concern when using directly injectable methods. This was a major concern for us because we wanted to develop a method that was both safe at the animal model level and human patient level. In vivo jetPEI is a safe method of delivery when following our recommendations, including maximum concentration of nucleic acid that can be injected, frequency of injections. We could show in mice model that following injection of nucleic acid systemically, here IV injection, the level of pro-inflammatory cytokines remain quasi-null compared to their induction following LPS stimuli. We also checked whether hepatotoxicity could be detected when compared to injection of CCL4 subcutaneously. As shown here, you can nicely see that in vivo jetPEI nucleic acid, sRNA or poly-IC nanoparticles did not induce hepatotoxicity compared to CCL4. Before starting human clinical studies, the safety of in vivo jetPEI nucleic acid-based therapy is assessed during preclinical studies, usually performed in larger group of the same animal model or in larger animal models such as non-human primates to evaluate the biodistribution, safety, and pharmacokinetics. These data are often not published, but you can refer to the publication mentioned here as an example. So now I've given you a general overview of the in vivo delivery methods, followed by a focus on our in vivo transfection reagent in vivo jetPEI. Now, in this third part, the idea is to give the handover to datasets and let them speak for the use of in vivo jetPEI for diverse applications. In this first case study, the authors are studying the role of protein annexin A2 in a severe polymicrobial sepsis model, CLP, that closely resembles human sepsis. Severe sepsis is associated with dysfunction and failure of critical organs. Annexins are a family of phospholipid-binding proteins, among which annexin A2 is studied because it appears to have a key role in inflammatory response. The authors use a transgenic mice model in which annexin A2 is knocked out on both alleles. They could show that, in the absence of annexin A2, there was an increased inflammatory response, which in fine led to a reduced survival rate of the mice, as illustrated in figure B. It's the red line. To consolidate their observation, they performed an in vivo rescue study in which they delivered plasmid DNA expression wild-type annexin A2 and several mutants using in vivo jetPEI by systemic administration to target the colon tissue. As shown in figure A, they could nicely detect expression of overexpressed annexin A2 in mutants 24 hours post-transfection in the colon tissue of wild-type and annexin A2 knockout mice. This overexpression of wild-type annexin could improve the survival rate of the mice, purple line, while the cysteine 9 mutant led to a similar outcome to delivery of an empty plasmid vector or no plasmid control in the annexin A2 knockout mice. In the second case study, a complete different set of conditions has been used by the authors. The nucleic acid is now sRNA. The organ targeted is the central nervous system. And for this, they chose to deliver sRNA in vivo jetPEI complexes by local administration, intranasal delivery. The aim of the study was to investigate the therapeutic potential of intranasal sRNA delivery using in vivo jetPEI to the brain to target a gene called Beclin-1. The efficiency of intranasal sRNA delivery was assessed in the normal mouse brain by triple fluorescence imaging with FITC-labeled sRNA, cell type-specific labeling, and DAPI staining. Here are images of brain sections of each tested conditions. PBS only injected, no FITC-labeled sRNA can be detected. In vivo jetPEI FITC-labeled sRNA, green signal can be detected already at 4 hours and further increased at 24 hours post-transfection. I've now given you an overview of what can be achieved at the animal model level to confirm in vitro results and to create genetically transient models to study human diseases. Now I would like to focus on in vivo delivery of nucleic acids as a novel promising approach for gene therapy. In vivo jetPEI is the most widely used chemical reagent to deliver nucleic acids in animals, and therefore it is selected as the delivery vector of choice in several drug development programs. Specifically for preclinical and clinical trials, we provide higher quality grades in vivo jetPEI PC and GMP in vivo jetPEI with the necessary quality control and regulatory documents required to advance to preclinical studies, clinical trials, and in fine, commercialization. So who has made it with in vivo jetPEI to the preclinical and clinical stage? Here is a list of ongoing clinical trials that I can share with you. As you can see, different types of nucleic acids, plasmid DNA, long double-stranded RNA, sRNA, as well as different administration routes are being used for different therapeutic strategies, mostly for cancer gene therapy and immunotherapy. This really illustrates the versatility and strength of our method. Our most advanced customer is Anciano Therapeutics, who are developing a bladder cancer gene therapy. We were really excited to hear that they had started the pivotal phase study with their lead candidate. So how does their bladder cancer therapy work? On a molecular level, in vivo jetPEI transfection reagent is able to encapsulate and condense the plasmid DNA into less than 100 nanometer nanoparticles. These in vivo jetPEI DNA nanoparticles are infused in the bladder of patients and taken up by bladder cells through endocytosis. Once inside the cells, the plasmid DNA is actually only activated in bladder cancer cells that overexpress H19 transcription factors. Because the H19 transcription factor is necessary to bind to the H19 regulatory sequence that will drive expression of the diphtheria toxin A that inhibits protein synthesis and leads to cell death of the cancer cells. You've seen what can be done using our in vivo transfection reagent. Now we're on to the interesting bit, getting you started with your in vivo experiments. We have several tools that are available. First and foremost, our transfection database that you can easily access by going on the PolyPlus transfection website. You can search through our publication database by organ, nucleic acid delivered, and you will find more than 400 in vivo publications available. In addition to the transfection database, you will find on our website technical notes and scientific posters, such as guidelines for nucleic acid delivery, providing you with starting conditions for different administration routes in mice, and later scientific posters available for download. And if you have more questions, a dedicated scientific support team ready to assess feasibility of your in vivo approach, provide references per targeted organ nucleic acid administration route, design tailored protocols for your animal model. To contact us, you can either use the contact us form on the PolyPlus transfection website or directly write to support@polyplustransfection.com.